Hey guys, today's play a game of House in Fata Morgana. So this is a visual novel, actually originally released in 2017, but this is a Switch version that came out last year, 2021. And yeah, this is a visual novel in the strictest sense of the word. Like, there's pretty much no interaction. It's just reading. Like, even compared to other visual novels, like other visual novels might have a little bit of interaction. This visual novel has none. So it's just reading. And I think the story is kind of intriguing and goes through several. Basically, the main plot of the novel is it's set in different time periods in this mansion, and you can see the stories unfold throughout different time periods and go through different reincarnations of the same character and stuff. It's kind of like a complex story. Now, it's not going to compare to like the greatest physical novels or anything like that, so don't expect it to be like, you know, a classic physical novel or anything like that, right? It's not Charles Dickens. It's not like, you know, not Great Gatsby, it's not To Kill a Mockingbird, not Lord of the Rings. Don't compare it to any of the great physical novels or anything. Grapes of Wrath, don't compare it to that. But as just like a visual novel, it's a pretty decent story. So if you guys are looking for, you know, just a good read, except you have obviously visuals as well, then I think this is a good pickup. Because I think this is a game that's really meant for people who like reading, but in this one, obviously, you get the visuals as well. So I would say that in terms of actually being, you know, a novel in the strictest sense of the word, if you just want to do some reading and just want a really interesting story, then this is it, right? It's not that much gameplay. It's really just reading throughout the story, but it's an interesting one, I think. So yeah, just keep your expectations kind of like that for this game. It's not technically that much of a game. Yeah, it's not going to compare to the greatest physical books or anything like that. But as far as like a story goes, you know, in terms of a visual novel plotline, yeah, it's pretty interesting, complex. So yeah, this is set in one of the time periods in this mansion. I think this is the earliest time period. I think it's the 1600s for this one. But there's a white-haired girl who's a servant in the mansion. She's actually a reincarnation of a different girl in a different time period. I think she was cursed or whatever by a witch. Anyways, this white-haired girl, Nellie, is one of them. She's like a character in this time period. She's a sister of Lord Mel, who is the main character of this time period. And Nellie she's kind of a psycho, actually. She has, she loves her brother, and I really do mean that she loves her brother. And yeah, because she's so in love with her brother, she basically goes kind of insane, because obviously her brother's not interested in her because she's his sister. He's interested in this white-haired girl, and because of his interest in this white-haired girl, because Nellie actually loves her brother so much, she gets jealous of his interest in this white-haired girl. And then she kind of does some psycho things. Anyways, you can see throughout this dialogue here. Yeah, so Lord Mel is the main character in this time period. And this is his sister Nellie, who's in love with her brother. And she gets jealous about the white-haired girl being her brother's love interest. And she thinks that the reason why he's interested in her is because of her white hair color. Yeah, so obviously she's got some issues. And this game jumps back and forth between different time periods, and each of the time periods has their own interconnected, interwoven stories. So she decides to cut off the white hair girl's hair and then use it as her own, which is kind of creepy, but you know, that's how much of a psycho she is. Yeah. So the narrator is this maid in the current time period. She's talking through. This maid is the constant in all these time periods, because she apparently never ages, but she's lived through all these different time periods. flaxen color. That's actually another name for blonde hair. Flaxen colored hair is just blonde hair. His crazy sister Nelly, who is insanely jealous of the white haired girl because she wants her brother's love so much. Yeah. And he thinks that it's the white haired girl that he likes. Actually his sister that he just kissed. He should have stolen the white hair girl's hair. Sister is kind of psycho. She thinks that's the white hair that he fell in love with. Because she's psycho. Oh man. From that girl's hair. Oh man. She's crazy. She wants to commit incest, basically. also the art in this game is pretty unique. That's another thing that people like about this game is it's a rather complex story, I guess, for visual novel, and the art is and music is definitely a lot of focus on the art and music. So it definitely adds to the kind of creepy atmosphere of this game. Back to when they were kids. Again, I think this was the early 1600s in this story. I think this is about 20 hours into the game already. Uh-oh, something's happening in the background. Thank you. was worried that he was interested in a girl who was basically his half-sister. That was that time period. So this game kind of jumps between different time periods. I should say this visual novel. Yeah, so we'll go to one time period, then go to another. So I think that was the earliest time period, was the 1600s time period. And yeah, the art in this game is pretty unique. It looks very realistic. And it's a Japanese game. Usually Japanese games have like anime style art. But this game has more realistic looking art.
Thank you.
This is the other story that happens in 1707. And what happens in this time period is actually pretty violent, because the what happens in this time period is the mansion is basically abandoned, except for basically what is a beast. There's a beast dwelling in the lower chambers of this cellar, basically, of this mansion. That's really the only person that's in this mansion in this time period, in the 1707. Yeah. Human, but like a beast person who lives off of killing people, basically. A beast. A beast. Basically, in this time period, you play as the beast, who is really half sort of human, but not really. Here the beast is trying to become more like a human, but you know, eventually he'll slip back to being a beast sometimes. Thank you. warning people who have epilepsy to not look at that part of the game. Many flashes. So he's becoming more and more like a human now. Instead of like a bestial person. So he's trying to be like a human, but I think he's gonna have a hard time keeping it together because he's still gonna slip back into his beast type of mentality. Slipping back into his beast form. Yep, he cannot pretend to be a human. He devolved back into a beast. And this was his, that merchant's bride or beloved or whatever, Pauline. That he killed. The Impaler or the Blood Countess or something. See, this is the white girl reincarnated in this time period. she's the one to get him to change back into human, to become more human again.
Thank you.
Yeah, she's blind. So she helped turn him back to being a kind of like a normal person. We're trying to turn him back to be a normal person. Like Beauty and the Beast now. Beauty and the Beast. to see what color it is. Does it matter? It's white or not. Alright, let's go back to the other story between Pauline and the merchant guy who the beast killed. But anyways guys, stop here, but this is House in Fata Morgana.
So yeah, I think people should pick up this visual novel if they want something that has a few like creepy supernatural elements to it, but it's not like full-on horror or anything like that. Yeah, they should check it out. It's got a fairly complex plot to it. It's nothing like, you know, physical, one of the great physical novels or anything like that, but for like a visual novel on a console, it's got a fairly complex plot, I think. And yeah, for people who just want to do a little bit of reading, they won't want something that has too much interaction, then this is definitely something to pick up. So yeah, that's it guys. House of Fata Morgana. Definitely check it out. And if you want something that's heavy on reading, not as much interaction, but you want something that has like a more complex plot, and you like, you know, the music and the art is great as well. So definitely check it out, guys. Thanks for watching.